doing a Rao shot here. We're at 90 degrees. Our goal, we're going to rise to 9 bar after pre-infusion, hold for 10, decline to 5 bars over 30 seconds time. There we are, we're using a bottomless, which I'll show you. So let's go hit save. That's just debug information showing me that the write has worked, and now I'm starting. This is the previous shot we just ran. It'll erase itself as soon as the new chart, as soon as the new shot starts. Final heating means we're heating the water temperature to the 9 degrees. Our basket temperature is currently at 89, so we're 1 degree off inside the basket here. Now we're pre-infusing, the chart has started. And if I tap here, you can see the pressure. We're still in pre-infusion, the pressure is not started. And then right around 12 seconds, boom, it detects right there, see it? That's a slight increase in pressure, which causes us to notice that we should go up. Now what happened here is we went to 11 bar, settled back down to 9, so we overshot a bit, which is something that happens with very slow flow rates. And then here's our flow rate here, which is right around 1 mil per second. In fact, you can see 1.13 mil per second. Here's what our shot looks like. You can see the decline happening now. And we should stop the shot any second now. Okay. So that shot there came out at 44 grams from 16 grams of coffee, which is probably a bit more than we want. And let's look at this. You can see that the flow rate increased slightly over time, right? So I would say we should pick a more of a decrease here if you want that flow rate to stay constant. And here's our temperature. The dotted line represents our goal. So we were under, and then we started to go, and then from basically 20 seconds on, we were bang on our goal. So here I am, I'm gonna make another modified Scott Rao profile. So we're gonna have pre-infusion, climb to 8.4 bar, hold for 10, decline over 25 seconds. Now we found that a decline of 30 seconds was too long. We also found previously that a final pressure of 5 yielded an increasing flow rate, decreasing the pressure to 3 fixes that. So we hit save. This information scrolling by is just for me as the programmer, so I know it's saved. You won't have all this noise on your screen. Let's go ahead and start. And we are weighing our shot here. At this point, it's doing final heating, and you can maybe hear tick, 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 tick. That's water at the mix temperature of 95, 96, 92, mixing in, going all the way right behind the basket, getting to exactly the right temperature. Now it's hit the right temperature, and what you'll see here is that line there is our goal temperature, and that's the actual temperature of the coffee grounds, and the water mixing is going up and down around that to try and get to the temperature we want. And right now our basket temperature is spot on at 90 degrees, 89 degrees, so we're really close to where we want to be. This line here shows us pre-infusion ended, so we had here pre-infusion here was pressure, water going in and no pressure, and then as soon as pressure was detected, it ramped up, went up here, it overshot a little bit, and hit 8.4. This is our hold, and this is our decline. Here is our flow rate. That's our pre-infusion flow rate of 2 milliliters per second. When pressure first, when the flow first increased into there, the pressure increased, but the puck needed to hit about this point in order to get compressed. And as soon as the puck got compressed, the flow rate collapsed down to that. And you can see our flow rate is very, very constant thanks to this declining pressure curve here that went from 8.4 bar down to 3, compensating for the erosion that happens during the coffee puck's life. And then here, the line to pay attention to is the dark red line. And what that's doing is trying to match the dotted line's temperature, and you can see for most of the shot, we were bang on it. Okay. The light line is us adjusting the temperature of the hot water mix going in to make sure that the infusion temperature is actually spot on. And that's our shot. We did 40 grams in the end with that, which was a bit more than we wanted. So we'll probably want to adjust the timings in the next one. So this is our second attempt at a Rao shot. In the previous one, our final pressure was 5, and we found that the flow rate was going up too high, so we lowered the final pressure to 3. Our decline time is also shortened by 5 seconds because we had 42 grams in cup, and that's more than we wanted. The lower final pressure and the 5 seconds off will cut quite a bit off the final in-cup weight. And let's hit save. Those are just debug messages telling me, the programmer, that everything's okay. Those won't be something that normal people have to see. And then we hit start. We can see that our basket temperature is at 90, our mix temperature is coming up. Okay, and it's just making sure that the whole machine up to the group head is at 90 degrees. And as soon as that's the case, pre-infusion will start. Pre-infusion has started. Here's this chart, and you can see here the pressure is very low. In fact, if you look at the pressure, it's extremely low pressure. And then as soon as, I'm going to put the line here, as soon as the pressure goes above 0.75, boom, there's our end of pre-infusion. That green line is our goal. We're going for 9 bar. We've overshot a little bit, which is something that happens if we have a slow flow rate. You can see that the flow rate increased as we increased pressure until a certain point, somewhere around 5 bar, where it compressed the puck and flow rate decreased. Here's what we're doing for temperature. So we're currently aiming for that line there, which is 90, and you can see the basket temperature is pretty much on that. It started a bit low, it overshot 90, undershot. At the end of pre-infusion, we were close to where we wanted to be. Okay. And now the shot has stopped. We've had a decline down to 3 bar. That gave us 31.6, which is actually exactly what I wanted, because I do a 2-to-1 shot, 16 grams in, 32 out. So this timing, this worked. Let's take a look at the flow rate and see what happened there. Our flow rate did not increase. Look how solid that is. It's at about 1 the whole way. So I would say, at least for this coffee shot, which is 16 grams in, having a decline from 9 bar to 3 bar maintains my flow rate at a constant 1 and does not increase its speed. So that's probably, well, that's what I'm going for in this case. Okay, and then if you look at temperature, our temperature here was under. That's the cooling effect of the coffee grinds. And then we put some hot water in. We overshot slightly, so we underdid it. Let it come down. It undershot. Now, bear in mind, we're talking about 1 degree here. So it maybe reached maybe 90.8, maybe 89 here. And then here it is settling at second 20 at exactly the temperature you wanted. So that's the goal of the basket temperature and the pressure, temperature profiling varying to make sure we maintain it.